Hey everybody, Saber here, and today we are doing a quick vid about the newest Pixar movie, Onward. Onward has had an interesting start, and by that I mean it's not doing so hot in the box office, and it's not crushing it with ratings either. Now that being said, I'm not saying that the film is a failure by any means, though I might date this video by saying so. As of right now, in March of 2020, we're going through a bit of a pandemic with this coronavirus thing, you know? Everybody's talking about it, and in the line of fire are many industries, and one of those being movies. Now, one could also say that it's not the virus, the movie's just not that good, or, hey, maybe it's a combination of both, I don't know. But I'll tell you my personal thoughts about the film, because I'll tell you this for sure, it is much better than Homeward. Good God Almighty, it's night and day. Onward is an original film by Pixar, and I'm glad that we are returning to that format. I'm not against them doing sequels, and I like quite a few of their sequels, but it sounds like Pixar is going into this decade saying that they want to make more original content, and I'm happy to hear that. And this year is no exception because we're getting two of them. We just got Onward here in March, and I believe we're getting Soul in July of this year. So, both exciting titles. You got Pete Docter working on Soul. He did Inside Out, he did Up, but that's another film. Let's talk about Onward. Onward is about two brothers. This movie is about family. It's about the relationship between Ian Lightspinner and Barley Lightspinner. I'm pretty sure that's their last name. I hope it's Lightspinner. Actually, I might be confusing it with the last name of the brothers from the Homeward movie. Dear God, as you can see, this film has still, it's cursed me. Oh, speaking of curses, right? By the way, spoilers for Homeward, not Homeward, God, I'm getting it confused. Onward, spoilers. Okay, so let me do a synopsis. What I liked, what I did not like. That's the three bullet points for this video. Synopsis, we follow Ian and Barley, two brothers who have discovered the ability and spell and magic to bring back their dead father for one day. But, oh no, there's a catch. They only brought back half of their father. They need a magic gem to complete the spell. So they go on a quest to go find that gem. That's the basic synopsis. Things I like about this movie. I like that it's gorgeous. It's a beautiful film. Great character designs. You can tell that Pixar is just once again mastering the art of computer animation with their lighting, with their hair effects, movement. It's just been top notch, and especially with their backgrounds. There are scenes in this movie where they're walking around mountains and plains, and it's gorgeous. It's getting to a point where it's almost hard to tell it from reality. As far as other things that I like, though, I love the relationship between the brothers. I thought I wouldn't at first, possibly because it could have been your typical generic, oh, my brother's loud, I'm quiet, I'm an introvert. We're got this dynamic where we don't get along, and that can get old because it's been done so many times before, and to which it has. But here, it works. Barley is the older brother. He's loud. He's very sure of himself. Very proud of himself. Not proud, but unapologetic. I wouldn't say that he's obnoxious, necessarily. He's just very... he's very comfortable in his own skin. You have Ian, voiced by Tom Holland. Oh, by the way, the voice casting for this was top-notch. I know that it's very common for movies nowadays to go, who's the current popular character, actor, whatever, not character, actor, but just actor, the Rock, go for The Rock. I'm glad that this movie saw the characters that needed voices and that Tom Holland could provide for the younger brother, Ian, and that Chris Pratt, his voice worked so well for Barley. That was great casting. I really enjoyed the voices for these characters. It worked very nicely. And also kind of funny how, I'm not sure about the personalities of the actors themselves, but it sounds like a bit of the personalities carried through into the performances, and that's always icing on the cake. So, Barley, very sure of himself. Ian, kind of an actually, I wouldn't even say he's an introvert. He's nervous, he's shy, he's got social anxiety, he's trying to make friends, but he doesn't have that confidence, that oomph, to give him a push forward to really seal the deal. And in all of it, he misses his father. He wants to see his dad. He never got the chance because his father died before he was born. Barley only got to see his dad for a few years of his life, if not even that. So you can tell that these brothers are hurting because they only have a mother and a stepfather. Not to say that family unit can't work for folks and have those folks feel fulfilled, but Ian, very much so, wants to meet his father. So like I said, the boys go on a quest to bring their father back from the dead. Apparently the father dabbled in magic. This is a world that was once riddled with magic, but technology took the forefront and magic kind of died out. And the father who used the magic spell, he like, okay, give this staff to my son when he's 16. Give it to Ian. And this staff is a wizard staff with a phoenix gem and a spell to bring back the father for one day. Only thing is that the gem was only good for half of the body and the legs were all that got through. And Barley and Ian go on a quest to go find another phoenix gem. So throughout the quest, they grow closer to one another with the ups and downs of adventure, them just bonding over the journey, ultimately bringing back the father. And you see how Ian grows as a character, being more sure of himself, how Barley tells Ian why he is the way that he is, where he's like, I am brave because Dad died and I was afraid of Dad dying, and after he died I told myself I would never be afraid again. And these are very beautiful themes, because the themes are about family, about brotherhood, about loss, about finding someone who can be that person in your life to help you grow and to be comfortable with yourself, which Ian discovers is actually Barley. Now, it was a journey, because you see how they don't really click at the beginning, but throughout the journey, Ian gets to know his brother better, they mesh, and I thought it felt organic, I liked it. You see also how, and this caught me off guard completely, how Ian made the decision, because he got caught under rubble during the final, like, climax of the movie, where he's like, Barley, you need to see Dad more than I do. As much as I would love to see Dad, you need to see him because you never got to say goodbye. And that was a beautiful moment. That caught me off guard. I gotta give it up to the movie. Props to you all. That was a good twist and very heartfelt, full of sacrifice and love, and it was not lost on me. I did not cry while watching this movie, but there were some points where I was emotional, where I'm like, oh, that's sweet, or that's sad, or that's beautiful. So overall, the main meat of this movie is the chemistry between the brothers. They nailed it. The setting itself being one that was fantasy that became modern, a combo of both. It's kind of like, instead of medieval humans with no magic becoming modern humans, you've got magical creatures who discover technology and then become modernized and kind of abandon magic. So that's my one big qualm, my one big issue with this film, is its explanation of how magic in this world disappeared. You have magic in this movie that can raise the dead. I feel like magic like that wouldn't be so easily forgotten. I know that the narrator said magic is difficult, and that more and more people said it was too tough to understand and gave up on it, and that over time it was lost. See, okay, I guess I see where you're coming from, but I feel like there would be at least some people who understand how important it is to study this stuff, especially if you can, again, create matter, make matter larger, shoot lightning, again, bring people back from the dead. These are incredibly powerful spells, things that I don't think people would be so easily to forget about or relinquish. Now, there's also this weird thing about how, like, they say, oh, Barley, he's an ultra nerd wizard guy who knows wizard spells but can't do it. So I guess they kind of give the impression that you need to not just know magic, you need to be born with it. But they never really flat out say it. They just kind of imply it by Barley holding a wizard staff and not being able to do magic, but Ian being able to hold the wizard staff and being able to do magic. So that was a little bit confusing where I'm like, wait, so are you born with it or do you just learn it? Is it innate? Is it taught? What is it? So that was confusing. Ultimately, though, I'd say that it's forgivable. I wish that there would be a segment in the movie where they would break that down a bit more, because I know they're like, oh, it's the old history of magic. We don't need to tear it down. And I'm like, yeah, but humans in this world aren't as quick to tear down history. We preserve it. We remember things. You know, there's still armor crafters. There are still people who do old school techniques because it's sentimental and important to them, though dated. I mean, we still have Renaissance fairs. So, but this is our world. That's their world. Again, it's forgivable. I just wish there was more of a solid explanation of like, no, not only is magic difficult, but it was fading from our world. Like almost like magic itself turned its back on those species because it was jealous maybe, or because it was finite. Something that would really drive home that magic is incredibly rare and not just difficult to understand, but like as a resource is hard to get your hands on. But small complaint. Overall, when it comes to Pixar's filmography, I would say this one is kind of middle of the road for Onward. Better than Brave, of course, much better than Cars 2, better than The Good Dinosaur. Not as good as, I'd say, Finding Nemo. Not as good as Wall-E or Up by any means either. Just right there, like comfortably in front of Monsters University, but right behind Coco. That's where I would put Onward. So, good film. I recommend it. It's a shame that it's getting beaten up at the box office. I wouldn't say it's bad at all. It's solid. I enjoyed it. Won't knock your socks off. But then again, it also depends on, I suppose, how connected you are to the topic this film is addressing. So, yeah, my friend Paleo, he's a only child, so it's kind of funny where he's like, eh, I don't really get it. But I have two sisters, and I'm like, oh, no, I can get it. I can see where it's coming from. So, teach their own. All right, those are my thoughts about Onward. Tell me what you all think in the comments, and I'll see you all next time. Later.